guys, my name is Arpita and I welcome you all back to my channel Flights of Fantasy. How to dress for your cabin crew assessment day is a critical factor to consider. Your appearance is going to dictate the quality of the first impression, which is a significant element on the path to success at your cabin crew interview. You are aiming to get a job in an industry that highly values appearance. The airlines want their flight attendants to be smiling, spotless, with shiny shoes, neatly ironed clothes, and charming look. When meeting someone new, we humans take a mere 30 seconds to form an opinion. We base our judgment on body language and appearance. The first impression cannot be altered at a later stage. Regardless of what you say or how well prepared you are for all the questions that you have to answer. You may think it is superficial, but this is how human beings function. We have no control over it. It has been shown that 55% of a person's opinion is driven by physical appearance. You want your interviewers to think the highest of you and offer you the job. In this video, let's focus on polishing your appearance, dressing for success on your assessment day, and creating a positive first impression. On the assessment day, you should ideally wear a skirt suit. A skirt is feminine and, in most cases, a compulsory part of the uniform. The length of the skirt is another important aspect that you would like to consider. Aim for the middle of your knee as the minimum length and half of your calf as the maximum length. You may want to test how the skirt looks when you sit down. You don't want it to slide too high up or get wrinkled. Also, keep in mind that the group activities might require you to do some physical work. Create a puzzle on the floor, build a Lego construction, or arrange something, maybe some objects in categories. Now, if you have to bend down, you need to make sure that you remain decent. Your jacket should be fitted and elegant. If you prefer, you can wear a business dress and a jacket. Go for dark colors such as black, gray, navy, or brown, and stay away from the bright colors or patterned models like bright green or pink, flowers, or animal prints. Now let's get to the shoes. Wearing shoes with a high heel will give you a great posture, making you feel taller and more confident. Go for a comfortable shoe in a classic style that you can walk in, stand on, and spend many hours wearing it. Now, pumps are ideal. Kitten heels are the minimum height and 7 to 8 centimeter should be your maximum height. Now, avoid strappy sandals, open toes, bright colors such as gold or silver, decorative stones, platform shoes that are too high or flat. If you would consider going out to a bar or club with the shoes you have, probably they're not the best choice for your interview. For the safest choices, go with colors such as black, brown, tan, dark gray, or even navy. Don't hesitate to wear colors such as deep green or red. If they're the only item of color in your outfit and they are paired with same color scarf or lipstick for that matter. For example, a red shoe can be worn with a black shirt, white or a black shirt and red lipstick. Or a green one can be paired with a dark gray skirt, black shirt, and a green scarf. Do not forget that you will be required to remove your shoes for the arm reach test. So your pantyhose should be intact and your pedicure should be spotless. Now let's talk about the hairstyle. A flight attendant always keeps an elegant hairstyle. Now, somebody who wants to be a flight attendant should do the same thing. If you have long hair, tie it in a neat bun at the back of your head and secure it with some pins and a bit of hairspray. If you have a pixie crop, style it neatly. As a rule of thumb, if your hair can reach your shoulder, it should be tied back. You can make a donut bun or you can also make a French knot. But yes, it should be very neatly done up. Search for pictures of the airlines, flight attendants, and copy their makeup. Natural colors such as gray and brown works the best. Start your makeup session with a concealer or foundation to even out your skin if you need it. Follow by applying eyeshadow on your upper eyelid and a coat or two of black or brown mascara. I would suggest that you go with black. Black is the safest color that you can use. A bit of blush following the natural contour of your cheek as a final touch. A nude or red shade of lipstick. Avoid lip gloss as you will probably eat it during the first few hours of the day. A good lipstick looks much more professional. Now, avoid smoky eyes and metallic shades as well as too much blush or too much mascara. You want to look like yourself after you've had an excellent night's sleep. Your manicure and pedicure should also be taken care of. Nails clean and of medium length, not too long, not too short, with a transparent coating or a neutral color. Avoid pointy nails, nail arts, nail designs, as well as fluorescent or too dark colors. When it comes to makeup, guys, remember less is more. Now, there is one accessory that without a doubt belongs to the flight attendant's world. Do you guys have any guesses? Okay, no guesses. It's a scarf. Yes, a delicate silk scarf will give you that extra touch that will make the potential employers imagine you wearing the airline scarf. You can wear it around your neck with a double or simple knot on the side, or you can tie it loosely in front of you or just without any knot visible. It'll make your neck look longer and will keep your spine more erect. You cannot go wrong with wearing a scarf on your big day. It is worth mentioning though that when taking the application photos, a scarf is not an item you should wear. As for the other accessories, have a minimalistic approach to it. Keep it simple and tasteful. Stud diamonds or pearl earrings, a delicate necklace, a small watch. Avoid any kind of artisan earrings, plastic or wooden beads necklaces. Bangles or too many rings with big stones or complicated design. Don't forget the most important ingredient, that's your smile. Yes. A warm and confident smile will put both you and the other person at ease. A positive, smiling face will make the person you talk to immediately perceive you as a friendly, helpful, positive, and a person easy to work with. When dealing with something unpleasant, smile and immediately you will feel a dose of optimism. And so will everybody else around you. We do search for one particular sign on a new face, a smile. We can pick up a smile from 30 meters away. A smile lets us know that we are likely to get a positive reception, and it's hard to not reciprocate to a smile. And the world is going to smile back at you too. So now that you have all this valuable information, go out to your closet and create your perfect interview day outfit. Try it on, try taking your picture while wearing it, and picture yourself entering the interview room confident and looking amazing with that dashing smile. This is the winning formula, guys. I wish you all the very best. If you like this video, please do hit on the like button. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Share it with all your family and friends. I'll be very soon back with you guys with yet another interesting video. Till then, you stay happy and healthy. This is Arpita signing off from Flights of Fantasy.